My name is Sujit Billa, Registered Migration Agent here in Melbourne. This video is about ACS Skills Assessment, a tribunal case where the applicant got positive or suitable outcome, then went on to apply the 189 visa and then got refused because of a verification done by the department. This experience is related to one company which the applicant claimed was absorbed or acquired by another company, and he also used the word amalgamation. In Oxford Dictionary, it is two things getting into one, or a mix of two into one. What he said was the first company was acquired by the second company, and later on said the first company was not acquired by the second company, but simply the second company took over some of the projects that were remaining in the first company when it was going to close. And the second company also gave a couple of letters from HR. In one of the letters, they said the first company was never acquired by them. In the other letter, they said this guy was actually an employee working for them and previously worked for the first company. So there were inconsistencies in the letters from HR, inconsistencies from the applicant about the acquisition, and also when it was put to the applicant, when department tried to verify the location of the employer and they picked up that the address was actually the same address for some other company, and the applicant said ACS only needed a company but not the physical location of a company, or the company should exist in reality. They only needed a company and I provided them and they gave me the positive skills assessment. The department also checked the domain name registration for the website related to the employer, and also looked at the website of the second company which apparently absorbed or acquired the first company. And then they said the website of the second company looks like a clone to some other website. Also, they tried to locate the director's information in social media, and they said that there was a stock image, or the images that we get to use for free on the internet, Creative Commons type. So the director's information has got a stock image, which means it appears to be fake. So the department thought that this 2 years of experience was fake experience, and they created, they manufactured some evidence from one company apparently registered with a name but never operated, because they tried to reach out to the employer by phone number and also email address, and the applicant said they were not able to reply because the department clearly said that they tried to reach out and there was no response. There was no response. And the applicant said because of lockdown, they couldn't reply to phone calls. Then the tribunal said, because this guy went to the tribunal, the tribunal said, what about email address? Everyone is operating from their home, more operating from their home during COVID, and they can very well reply to the email. Then finally, the tribunal agreed that it was fake experience and agreed with the decision of the department in refusing the case. But this case was refused under PIC 4020, the public interest criteria. 4020 is very deadly, and this was refused under that ground. But there is a provision under PIC 4020 where the department can actually waive PIC 4020 if there are compassionate or compelling grounds. In this case, this applicant is working in Australia. Maybe he came on a temporary visa. In fact, he came on a student visa, then studied a master's degree, and he also argued, well, you gave me the student visa, you did not check, and you did not comment on the employment, because I have mentioned that in the student visa application. Or maybe the department did not verify at that stage. Usually when you come to the permanent residence stage, the verifications take place, more verifications take place. And if you go to the citizenship stage, there will be further more verifications that were not in place at permanent residence also. So remember that. And the moral of the story is, even if you get ACS positive, you can still get a refusal at the end of the day. Back to this case, so there were these provisions, or there still are provisions under PIC 4020 if there are compelling and compassionate grounds, or compelling or compassionate grounds. In this case, there was this farmer who took help from this applicant, and he was working in some other job, and they also depended on him. And he was also working as a database professional for an ICT company. And they gave a letter that because of skill shortages and due to the current global pandemic, we are very much in need of this employer who was very helpful to us in the recent past, and we need him to be in Australia. And please do not refuse the permanent residence application. So the tribunal considered that and thought that PIC 4020 should be waived, which means that the department probably should take another decision, which is not to refuse his visa application, and he remitted the case, which means it requests the department to take another decision. So the moral of the story here is, there are grounds under PIC 4020, but this is not about that. It's about presenting a story, if it is a true story, in a detailed manner, because there could be some companies where they were absorbed, acquired, and they are real work experiences, not fake like this. But if presented in a way that the department doesn't like it, or the department thinks that it is unverifiable, then it could be a ground for refusal. It's the same with ACS now, because these cases in the recent past I mentioned in the videos are all done. I mean, the ACS skills assessment was done before December 2019, where you only have to provide work reference letters but not payment evidence. If you are in a situation where one of the companies you worked in the past was acquired by the other, and you have only limited information or documents, and you do not know what else to get, you can ask me immigration advice, or even ask me to do your case to submit to ACS. All it takes is for you to contact me by email. Email me your resume and a list of questions to info@sujittalks.com, and we can take it from there. Thanks for watching this video. My name is Sujit Billa, registered migration agent here in Melbourne. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, Sujit Talks, and click on that bell icon to get more of these ACS skills assessment videos. Also follow me on LinkedIn.